Good morning, students. Welcome back in your SS class. Students, we have completed our first chapter of history. And from this video lecture, we'll start second chapter of history, that is New Kings and Kingdoms. In the previous video, and you can say in the previous chapter, I have told you that in 7th standard, we will discuss from 8th century to 18th century, that is considered medieval period. Right, students? And we have also discussed a few things related to the medieval period also, that new kings and new kingdoms, they were formed. Now in this video lecture, we will start this thing also, that during the medieval period, which new kings and which new kingdoms, they were emerged. We will discuss this thing in this video lecture. So dear student, before discussing, and you can say before beginning the chapter, first of all, we'll see the topics which we will cover in this chapter. First of all, I'll give you the introduction of the chapter. It would be a little bit introduction. Then we will discuss about the emergence of the new dynasties. Dynasties, it means new empire. You can say that. Means in the medieval time period, you can say that from 8th century to 18th century, new dynasties, new empire, they were emerged. Which were the empires and how they were emerged, we will discuss all these things. Then we will see the administration of these kingdoms, which type of administrative system they have adopted, and how the kingdoms, and you can see how the government govern. We will discuss all these things in this chapter. After then, we will discuss about two important terms, that Parsathis and land grants. What is the Parsathis and what is the land grants? We will discuss this thing in this chapter. After then, we will discuss about warfare for wealth. Hence, there would be some conflict between, you can say, among different rulers due to wealth. So we will discuss this thing in this video lecture also. And after then, we have one case study, that is Cholas. So we will have a close look related to Cholas. By getting this case study, we came to know that what type of administrative system and what type of, you can say, that system of agriculture and other things, it is going on in the kingdoms during that period. So we will take example of the Cholas, and we have the case study of this thing, and we came to know about this new king and new kingdoms. Right, friends? So let's start the chapter. So my dear student, if we think about between 7th century to 12th century, now we are concentrating only time period from 7th century to 12th century. There were many dynasties which were emerged at that time. You can see in the map. If you see in the map, we have seen a lot of dynasties. They were ruled all over the India. And these are different dynasties. If we think about the northern part of India, there were Chauhans. And everything about the, you can say, north, eastern part of India, like west, in the area of the West Bengal, we have Palas. And everything about the southern part, we have Rashtrakutas, and you can say Chers, Pandes, and Cholas also. So if we see at that time, if you see, you can say the map of during that time period, means from the 7th century to 12th century, we saw that a lot of new kingdoms, they were emerged in India. These were the dynasties of the Gujjar Pratiharas, Rashtrakutas, Palas, Cholas, and the Chauhans. These were the dynasties. Right, students? So we have to discuss all these things in this video lecture. So first of all, we will cover our first topic, the emergence of the new dynasties. Means, which new dynasties were emerged during this period? First of all, we will discuss this thing. Student, we have been discussing time period from the 8th century to 18th century. So first of all, we'll start it from the beginning. By the 7th century, there were many big landlords and warrior chiefs. They have started to emerge in the different part of the Indian subcontinent. मीन्स अगर मैं 7th century की बात करता हूँ तो इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट के अंदर जो डिफरेंट बिग लैंडलॉर्ड्स एंड वॉरियर्स जो थे वो उस वक्त इंडिया के अंदर आए थे, वो उस वक्त इंडिया के अंदर वो न्यू एमर्ज हुए थे, राइट स्टूडेंट्स। बट एट दैट टाइम जो एग्जिस्टिंग किंग थे दे थॉट देम एज देयर सामंतास एंड देयर सुबोर्डिनेट्स, मीन्स दीज बिग लैंडलॉर्ड्स एंड दीज बिग वॉरियर्स व्हाटएवर दे वर एमर्ज इन द इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट एट दैट टाइम दोज हु वर इन द पावर they thought them, they acknowledged them as their samantas, as their subordinates. Means, वो उनके subordinate के रूप में काम करेंगे. And it was also expected that they would give them gifts, they would give them some gift also, and they would provide them military support also. ये भी expect किया गया था उस वक्त. Means, जो उस वक्त rulers हुआ करते थे, वो क्या कहते थे? कि जो ये new kingdoms emerge हुए ना, these were their samantas, their subordinates. And they were expected to bring gift for their kings and overlord also, and they will provide them military help also. This was believed at that time. But dear student, the Samantas, they started to get power and wealth slowly. So as these Samantas gained power and wealth, they declared themselves to be as a Mahasamanta, and you can say Mahamandaleswara. It means that the great lord of circle or region. जैसे इन सामंत को पावर और वेल्थ मिली तो उन्होंने क्या किया, अपने आप को इंडिपेंडेंट घोषित कर दिया. उन्होंने अपनी एज ए सामंता वो थे, उन्होंने अपनी डिग्री को ही चेंज कर दिया, अपने रैंक को ही चेंज कर दिया. दे वुड कॉल देमसेल्फ महासामंता या महामंडलेश्वर. इट मीन्स दैट कि वो उस एरिया के लॉर्ड बन चुके हैं, उस एरिया के राजा बन चुके हैं. And they asserted their independence from their overlord also. और उन्होंने अपने आप को independent घोषित कर दिया कि now they were not subordinate of that particular existing king of that particular overlord. उन्होंने अपने आप को independent kingdom के रूप में घोषित कर दिया. Now they emerge as a new independent kingdom, as a new independent you can say king also. Right friends? तो इस तरीके से 7th century में क्या हुआ? New big landlords and the warrior of the chiefs. They started to emerge in the Indian subcontinent as an independent rulers. अब वो एक independent ruler के रूप में काम करने लगे. Right friends? So let's take the example of it. Our first example is Rashtrakutas. If we think about Rashtrakutas, they were in the Deccan Plateau of India. There was a once they were the subordinate of the Chalukyas of the Karnataka. एक समय ऐसा था कि वो कर्नाटका के अंदर जो चालुक्य साम्राज्य था उनके सुबोर्डिनेट के रूप में काम करते थे. बट इन द मिड 8th सेंचुरी दांती दुर्गा हु वाज आवर चीफ ऑफ राष्ट्रकूटाज एट दैट टाइम ही ओवरथ्रू हिज चालुक्य ओवरलोड एंड इवन ही परफॉर्म अ रिचुअल दैट वाज कॉल्ड हिरण्यगर्भा. It means that the golden womb. Golden womb. Student, here you have one question, important question that, ki what does Hiranyagarbha means? Literally, it means that golden womb. And it was, this ritual was performed with the help of Brahmans. Now, what was this ritual? According to this ritual, it was thought that it would lead a rebirth of the sacrifier. He was made a Kshatriyas, even if he was not by birth, not a Kshatriyas. Now he, after this ritual, he became a Kshatriyas. It means that he would become an independent king. He would become a ruler. According to that thing. Right, friends? I think this concept is clear to all of you. मैंने आपको बताया कि 7th सेंचुरी के अंदर न्यू सामंतास अपनी अपनी शक्ति को बढ़ाने लगे और एज ए इंडिपेंडेंट नेशन के रूप में दे वर एमर्ज्ड. वी हैव सीन दिस थिंग, राइट? आई हैव गिवन द एग्जांपल ऑफ द राष्ट्रकूटास इन डेक्कन प्लेट्यू ऑफ इंडिया. दे वर वंस दे वर द सुबोर्डिनेट ऑफ द चालुक्याज ऑफ द कर्नाटका. बट राष्ट्रकूटास का एक चीफ था दांती दुर्गा. ही ओवरथ्रू हिज चालुक्य ओवरलोड. उसने चालुक्य ओवरलोर्ड को ओवरथ्रू कर दिया. इट मींस ही प्रोटेस्टेड अगेंस्ट हिम एंड ही टोल्ड देम दैट ही वुड बी द न्यू इंडिपेंडेंट किंगडम. ही परफॉर्म. अब देखिए दांती दुर्गा क्या था, वो जस्ट ओनली एक सामंत था. तो उसने क्या किया, एक रिचुअल, एक नई परंपरा स्टार्ट की ब्राह्मण्स की हेल्प से, जिसे हम कहते हैं हिरण्य गर्भा, एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट रिचुअल इट वॉज टू बी थॉट दैट इट वुड लीड अ न्यू बर्थ ऑफ द सेक्रीफायर एंड नाउ ही वुड बी अ क्षत्रियाज. बाय बर्थ ही वॉज नॉट अ क्षत्रिय बट after this ritual he would be a kshatriya and at that time these kshatriyas they would be the king of that particular kingdom. ab wo kingdom ka king mane jane laga. humne yahi padha tha na ki jo raja ka beta hota hai wahi raja ka beta banega. we have studied all these things right. now question arises here ki jo ye rashtrakutas the they were not by birth any kshatriyas, so that's why they did this ritual and after doing this ritual there would be a rebirth of the sacrificer, means there jo ye sacrificer tha jis vyakti ne is ritual ko perform kiya tha with the help of brahmana, he would become a kshatriyas. now he would be the ruler of that particular kingdom. this was the example of that samanta. kyunki is prakar se jo new samanta the they got the power and they started to become the king, new kings. now let's take the another example also. men from the enterprising families, it means that men from the business families, those who use their military skill to carve out kingdoms like the Kandamba Nus Ashrama and Gujjar Pratihara Harichandra. these were the two example. ab inka profession kya tha, they were the enterprising families, they belong to enterprising families, but everything about it, these people, they were the brahmans. wo brahmans the but they gave up their traditional professions. ab in vyaktiyon ki agar main baat karta hu, by birth they were brahmans but they gave their traditional professions and they took the arms, they took arms, arms it means weapons, and successfully they established their kingdom in Karnataka and in Rajasthan respectively. so in this way we can say that in the 7th century the new kingdoms they were emerged. They were not these new king, and you can say these new kingdoms, they were not the before time, but after 17th century as they got the power, they started be the independent kingdom. right students, I think so this thing is clear to all of you. so in this way the new kingdom, they were emerged at during the 7th century. right. now let's focus the administrative system of these kingdoms. this would be very most important for thing, and it would be a long answer question for you also. we explain the administrative system of any kingdom like Cholas and any other thing. so we must have the knowledge about the administrative system of that particular kingdoms. if you think about these kingdoms, the king at apex, it means at the top, at the highest rank, they adopted different big titles like Maharaja Dhiraj. sabse pehle baat dhyan rakhne ki hai ki jo raja hota tha, he was the supreme power of the entire kingdom ke andar wo supreme power hai, he was at the apex, and these kings they adopted big titles like Maharaja Dhiraj. right friends, the first point. now the second thing, the administrative power, the kings shared this administrative power with other person also. kyunki akela vyakti to pure ke pure rajya ko nahi sambhal sakta, isliye usne kya kiya, apni in administrative powers ko share karna shuru kar diya with samantas, brahmans, traders, and you can say some associations of the peasants also. jo king tha usne kya kiya, these kings shared their administrative power with samantas, brahmans, traders, and you can see the association of the peasants also. right friends, in this way this was done so that the administration, it could be worked in an efficient manner. so that's why they shared their power. right friends, now think about some producer also, peasants, cattle keeper, artisans, and all other persons, these were the producers, and these persons they had to pay the tax or rents to the king, and if they were the traders, they had also to pay the revenue also. Now, these taxes to be paid to the king, because all the taxes, that taxes, they were the income of that particular king. जो भी हम टैक्स पे करते हैं ना वो हमारे देश की इनकम मान जाती है. सेम एज इट इज उस वक्त जो भी पीजेंट्स या कैटल कीपर्स या आर्टिस्ट्स जो भी टैक्स पे किया करते, दैट वुड बी द इनकम सोर्स ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर कम्युनिटी. एंड एट दैट टाइम इट वाज थॉट दैट अंडर द चोला डायनेस्टी देयर वर अराउंड 400 डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ टैक्सेस एंड दीज वर गिवन बाय द वेटीज. वेटीज इट मींस फोर्स्ड लेबर. And kadami, it means as a land revenue. These were very common, most common seen during the Chola dynasty. Right, friends? So, इस प्रकार से ये taxes जो थे वो दिया जाता था. Now, why government and why kings collect these taxes? Question arises here. भी हम tax क्यों pay करते हैं? उनको tax क्यों pay करना पड़ा? The basic reason for the collecting tax या for paying the tax it was to fulfill the finance things of the king's establishment. Means जो भी day to day life में जो भी खर्च होता है ना उसको finance करने में, to build new temples and fort also, and they have to fight war also, so the expenditure of these war also, and whatever those who are working in the administration, the salary and the wages also given to them. So, इन सब चीजों को पूरा करने के लिए टैक्स कलेक्ट किया जाता था. इन सब चीजों को पूरा करने के लिए टैक्स कलेक्ट किया जाता था. आई विल गिव यू अ लाइव एग्जांपल राइट नाउ. वी ऑल यूज द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एंड वी पे द बिल, इलेक्ट्रिक बिल. अगर मैं इस इलेक्ट्रिक बिल की बात करता हूं ना, दिस वुड बी यूज एज द सैलरी ऑफ द ऑल पर्सन हु आर वर्किंग इन द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बोर्ड. एंड उसके अंदर जो भी खर्च होता है कि भाई वो हमने कैसे बनाया, क्या किया, इन सब चीजों के अंदर जो भी खर्च होता है ना, उन सब चीजों के लिए इसका यूज किया जाता है. उन सब चीजों के लिए यूज किया जाता है. सो दैट्स वाई वी हैव टू पे टैक्स. इवन वी ऑल्सो पे इनकम टैक्स ऑल्सो. वो एक अलग बात है कि हमने से बहुत सारे इनकम टैक्स को बचाते हैं, बट दैट वुड बी अ रॉन्ग थिंग. बिकॉज डे टू डे एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन के लिए जो भी खर्च होता है, expenditure of the day-to-day administration, it must be fulfilled by these taxes. So we must pay the tax. Right, friends? Now let's come to the another point. If we think about the high positions of the kingdom, इसके अंदर army भी आ जाती है. The high positions of the kingdoms, they were appointed either by hereditary or through by the influential families also. Means, अगर किंगडम के अंदर अच्छी पोजीशंस की बात की जाती है, चाहे वो आर्मी की क्यों ना बात हो, या तो वो पुश्तैनी रूप से मिलती है, मींस फादर था उसके बच्चे को मिल गई, ठीक है, या फिर क्या होगा, कोई भी इन्फ्लुएंशियल फैमिलीज होती है उनके माध्यम से होती है. तो दिस इज द होल एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सिस्टम ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम पीरियड इन द किंगडम्स. रेस्टोरेंट वेयर द किंग्स ही वॉज द सुप्रीम पावर ऑफ द टोटल होल किंगडम एंड ही अडोप्टेड बिग टाइटल्स लाइक महाराजा धीराज. And for getting the efficient administrative system, he shared his administrative power with samantas, brahmans, and traders also. He also collected tax because that tax was the income of that country, so that the expenditure of the kingdom, it can be sorted out and it can be fulfilled. That's why these are done. So this was the administrative system in that particular kingdoms during the 7th century. Right, friends? I hope this concept is clear to you. Now, next point is parsities and land grants. What are the feature of this thing? What do you think about these important terms? We will discuss these thing in the next video lecture. So I'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Have a nice day.